Hey friends, welcome to Night Graphics. In this tutorial, we will make this neon text banner. Let's start drawing it. Before we start, make sure that the smart guides are on. Now pick the rectangle tool and draw an artboard sized rectangle. Keep its stroke to 0 and give it a dark fill. I'm going with the black here. Now come here to the layers panel. Lock this layer and name it BG. BG for background. Now create a new layer. Name it full text. In this layer, pick this text tool and click anywhere on the artboard. Here you see that the default text appears on the screen and is under selection right now. Change the fill color of this text to white. It makes it visible against this dark background. Change the font size to 350 from here. Now I am changing its font style to this Harlow Solid Italic. You may choose any other font as per your choice. Here I change the text. Now pick the black arrow tool. Right click on this text and select create outlines. You can see that the live text has been converted into object. Let us place it on center of the artboard. For this, open align panel. If you don't have this panel here, you will get it here in window menu. Now keep the shape selected and make sure that this align to artboard option is selected here. Press horizontal align center and vertical align center. Okay, now remove its fill and give it a stroke of 5 points. Alright, now we will change its stroke color. For this, come to the colors panel and make sure that stroke is selected here. Now open HSB options and dial 120 for hue, 40 for saturation and 100 for the brightness. Now come to the object menu and select expand. Check both stroke and fill and press OK. Now we have this shape with a green fill and zero stroke. Come to the layers panel and here mark a name for this shape. I'm naming it text1. Text1 is under selection. Now we want a copy of it. Simply press Ctrl C to copy and paste it in front by pressing Ctrl F. New copy is under selection. Now give it a stroke of 5 points. Open object menu, select expand. Keep this expanded shape selected. Come here at Pathfinder panel. If you can't see this panel here, come to the window menu and you will get it right here. Okay, so in the Pathfinder panel, press this unite button. Now name this newly formed group as text2. Now I will change the color tone of this text2. For this, open color panel. Make sure that fill is selected here and dial 120 for hue, 100 for saturation and 70 for brightness. Now keeping it selected, come to the effect menu, here blur, Gaussian blur and set its radius to 7. Alright, now we have to send this text2 to back. For this, keep it selected and right click on it. Here click on arrange and select send backward. Text2 is still selected. Press Ctrl C to copy and press Ctrl F to paste a copy of it in front. Name this copy text3. Now keeping text3 selected, come to the effect menu, blur and select Gaussian blur. As this effect is already applied to this shape, Illustrator warns you that you are about to apply another instance of this effect. Simply select apply new effect here and set the radius to 21. Set its opacity to 90% from here. Now come to the layers panel and place this text3 just above the text1. Now our main text is ready. Lock this layer, create a new layer and name it frames. In this frame layer, pick the pen tool, set the fill to none and select any stroke color for now. And now we will draw a frame around this text like this. You may use rectangle tool and go for rectangle 2 Now pick black arrow tool and select the shape. Open stroke panel. Set the stroke weight to 7 points and set the cap option to round. Come to the layers panel and name this shape frame 1. This whole shape is selected. Now click on white arrow tool. As you can see, all these corner anchor points are selected. Enter 50 here in this corners option. Frame 1 is still selected. Pick black arrow tool and come to color panel. Select stroke from here and dial 0 for hue, 20 for saturation and 100 for brightness. Keep it selected. Come to the object menu and click expand. Frame 1 is still under selection. Let us place it on center of the artboard. For this, open align panel. Make sure that the align to artboard option is selected here. Now press horizontal align center and vertical align center. Now we will create a copy of frame 1. For this, keeping it selected, press Ctrl C and then press Ctrl F to paste its copy in front. New copy is under selection. Give it a stroke of 7 points. Now come to object menu and expand this shape. Shape is still selected. Come to Pathfinder panel. Press this unite button. Now name this shape frame 2. Frame 2 is still under selection. Now we will adjust its color tone. For this, come to the color panel. Select fill from here and dial 0 for hue and 100 for both saturation and brightness. Now we will apply Gaussian blur to frame 2. For this, keep it selected. Come to the effect menu, blur, Gaussian blur, and set the radius to 7. Now send this frame 2 backward. For this, right click on the shape, click arrange and select send backward. Now copy frame 2 and press Ctrl F to paste its copy in front. Name this copy frame 3. And bring it to the front of frame 1 like this. Frame 3 is under selection. Come to effect menu, blur, Gaussian blur, click apply new effect and set the radius at 21. Set its opacity to 90%. Now select all three frames. Press Ctrl G to make them a group. I'm naming it group 1. Press Ctrl C. Now press Ctrl F to paste it in front. Name it group 2. Now finally, pick this rotate tool. Click here while pressing Alt key to set its axis at this point. And here in dialog box, enter 2 degrees for angle value. And here we are, the glowing neon text is ready. Hit like and share if you like this video. Stay connected for upcoming tutorials. Goodbye for now.